Season number 21 for you. Do you ever get bored?
Not currently, no. It's been great. You know, obviously another good winter, sort of practicing and training and working hard with the boys, trying to progress a few of the youngsters and get them going. But it's still exciting as ever when you get to this stage, when you've been indoors and it's been dark and gloomy and the sun's, you know, never come out, and then you come back out here. The grass is wet, it's soaking, it's freezing cold, but it's just a great fun and a great opportunity to get back out and start practicing and get ready for the summer.
I remember last year's pre-season press conference and everyone was in shorts and it was beautiful, yeah. Sunny looking up to the summer, so maybe this year it's going to be glorious, cracking the flags.
Yeah, I'm not going to be betting on it, that's for sure. We'll see what happens. Yeah, I think the weather plays a major part, doesn't it? I think, you know, over the course of the year, you've got to hope that you don't miss out on too much cricket, and it takes away opportunities to win games. So, you know, I think, you know, it pretty much balances itself out, and certain teams have it maybe slightly worse than others, but it's sort of fairly even as the course goes on.
Do you think you had it worse last season, the last couple of seasons? The Southwest seems to get more rain now.
Yeah, look, I think there's many a team who would probably put their hand up and say, look, we're unlucky. You know, I know Lancashire missed out on a hell of a lot last season. But that's the way it is. You know, there's nothing you can do about it. It's not like we can change and go and move somewhere. So we tend to get on with it and not worry about it too much.
A new start here. Dave Nosworthy coming in. How's the relationship with him and the coach, Andy Hurrigan, and yourself going to work out?
I think that'll take a bit of time to work on. I think we need to, you know, have that moment and just be together a bit. You know, we've talked a lot over the last few weeks, talking via Skype. You know, obviously, you know, Dave's been away, visa problems that you get nowadays. So we've done bits and pieces, but I think you still need to be as much as you can face to face to try and, you know, work out so you can see expressions and go from there. Meetings will continue on, obviously, quite regularly. Another one this afternoon just to sit down and work out things, and we can start sort of, you know, running him through players and see how everybody operates. And I think really over the next couple of weeks, month maybe, before the start of the proper games, that we can, you know, really bond that sort of management group that we need to get.
Do you think that new appointment is what you need to take you over from that second place into first?
I don't know, if I'm honest. I'm not sure how it's going to be, you know, how it's going to be different, how it's going to be, if that's the answer that we need. I think, as I say, time will tell how it's all going to pan out, how we're going to operate things. I think you want something different, you try and expect something's going to change, but we've got a lot of work to do in the meantime to make that happen, and it's really down to the players about trying to get the performances right. We're very consistent as we go along, but you've got to try and maintain that and keep it into the big occasion, and that's what our challenge is.
One of the discussions you're going to be having, of course, is this story that seems to be going around about your wicket-keeping situation. Quite ironic that last year, I think the season before, you had to bring in Steve Snell, didn't you? And now all the talk is about the abundance of wicket-keepers you've got.
Yeah, and that's the challenge that lays ahead, isn't it? We're very aware of all the talk that's been going on, obviously with Josh being current in the one-day team and then Craig missing out for a bit. That is tough. There's no immediate answer. With Dave only been here for one day, and getting to know the players and understanding what's going on, I don't think we know what our solution is at the moment. Whether, you know, who's going to keep him what, or and the opportunities that's going to arise for people. So a little case of sort of trial and error, I think, really over the next sort of few games, see how our boys operate and how good form it comes down. We've got to try and get the most and try and get them both in the right frame of mind to do well for Somerset, but the team must come first.
Club v country often comes in other sports, and less so in cricket. It seems that maybe that's why this is becoming such a big story now.
Yeah, it's the first time I've ever experienced it in such the magnitude that it is. Trying with both of them vying for the same position, that's why it's so awkward. But, you know, I think we just got to let it ride for a bit and see what we can get. Until then, you know, I don't think there's any solution right now.
Poor old Steve Snell, are you looking?
Well, I might pull my gloves back out myself, yeah. and sort of take it away from everybody and sort of go down that road, but we'll see what happens.
You spent a lot of last season out, which of course is very rare for you. How's the fitness?
I've worked pretty hard over the winter to try and get my ankle back into shape where I need it to be, get the strength back up into it. But since the sort of operation, the dynamics of my foot have changed a little bit, so I'm still going to maintain and get a few little niggles along the way. There's a little bone spur in there at the moment. It's just giving me a bit of grief here and there. But, you know, these injections nowadays that you tend to go through and stuff. So it's not the end of it. I don't think it'll ever be back to how it was really, you know, for the previous few years of my career. But I'll have to manage it and sort of try and keep on top of any problems that arise. So that's going to be the challenge for me this year.
So I can get down the bookies nicely easy now then and put lots of money on you getting 2,000 runs this season.
I can't advise you about going on betting on cricket, so that's really up to you to look at, Jed, I'm afraid.
A couple of other questions. Nick Compton, you're going to miss him all season, do you think now?
I don't know if it'll be all season. I think he'll be away for a fair part of it. Obviously, they've got the New Zealand series to start with back in England. And then they have, obviously, the big one of the Ashes. So I expect him to be away. I expect him to play a major part in that. I think you can see with our planning, a little bit with Alviro, that that's what we're sort of angling at. I think, obviously, expecting Nick to be involved. But we'll see what happens. I think he's done well, and I think he deserves a place to play against Australia. But he's got to keep maintaining and doing the hard work.
He's certainly a guy who puts a lot of work into his cricket.
Yeah, of course he does. He strives all the time to be better than what he has been before. So, we're not surprised at all. He goes out and gets back-to-back hundreds. We've seen him here for the last few years. When he gets going, yeah, he scores big runs. So, good luck, really.
Alistair Cook, meanwhile, breaking lots of records, scoring more and more hundreds. Did he ever call you up and say, Marcus, thanks for slipping out the England team so I got in earlier?
I don't think he's too worried about that. I think he's more focused on the job that he's got to do. He's a fantastic player, and I think, where can he go? What can he achieve is probably the question. He's doing great things at the moment, and every time he seems to get a score, he gets 100. And that's brilliant, really, because obviously leading from the front, you need your leader to do well. But I really challenge how far he can go, because I think it could be amazing. I think it could be up there with the best that have ever played the game.
Just think how many runs you would have scored had you carried on playing.
No, mate, no, I'm not sure. It's not something I've ever really sort of sat back and looked at. But, I think Cookie will do well.
Finally, the championship seems to be getting stronger and stronger every year. There's nine pretty good teams in that top flight this year. You're obviously expecting to win it, but who are the major challenges?
I don't know. I think anybody at the moment, as you saw with Lancashire the previous year, they won the championship, then got relegated. So I think it's always something to be wary of. Any team you can beat, any team you can lose to. That's the challenge that lays ahead for every game that we have the opportunity to play in. I don't think you can pick out. I think there's probably a group of six, seven, maybe eight who can possibly win the competition. So at the moment, who it is, I couldn't tell you.
Who's the one who's not going to win it then, if there's eight?
I don't know. Maybe nine. So I think there's... anybody could win at this stage.